So I agree with your point. It's going to bring a lot of transparency. It's basically a foundational technology, which is going to make sure accounting is done properly. There need not be any kind of meter. Of course, readings will be taken from the meter, but there's probably zero chance of even defaulting, because a lot of times this is going to be linked to tokens. And only if you have those tokens can you do any kind of trading in such sense. So, when you're selling power back to the grid, you need to make sure that those kind of tokens are available with the grid, which is going to be eventually linked to fiat currency. So, yes.
Pilot of this project already on?
Yes, we are working on one pilot, yes. But of course, once that comes to light, I'll share.
Devi, I think you had a...
So, as blockchain will make a market more deregulated, and just to mention, clarify, previously the comparison on price on Leh and Delhi is on storage side, not on solar. And all taking on the investment side, the solar industry is morely invested on the implementation part, not on the product development, because most of the products are outside India. There is very less investment in Indian scenario where there is development in products like PV panels or inverters, anything. But storage is more... you can tell it is more holistic market, where more of the investment is also going on the product development, like maybe BMS assembling, maybe on the newer technologies, which is already happened in India. I don't want to mention the names who have already got PE funding or venture capital funding, but on the project side also similar things will happen, which I already mentioned in the large scale project. But there is a small scale in commercial industrial segments, which is currently no need of directly funding. The reason is now the commercial industrial establishment, like critical infrastructures, like hospitals or these hotels or shopping malls, they're already paying more high prices for the diesel consumptions. So on diesel consumption, if they're paying like 23 rupees or 17 rupees, the storage integrated rooftop solar is directly a financial feasible solution. If they consider the LCOE is for an Indian scenario is around 7 to 8 rupees in solar integrated storage projects, which is directly giving a payback in 4 to 5 years. So this commercial industrial segment should be the first target of this renewable developer companies who want to diversify. But the issue is in renewable developer companies or EPCs, they all want to put their little finger on storage without analyzing the risk, which involves many things like technology selections, sizing of the technologies, the component selections, because storage as a cell label, it doesn't matter to anything. You have to integrate the PCS, BMS, controller, everything. So all these renewable companies put their little finger, not putting their full hand. So that is the issue on the renewable side. They should understand the storage as a whole. Because that will only make the Indian storage market or hybrid project will go ahead. On the other side, on the investment, when you are going for a larger scale, like if you are going investment in a newer technologies, you should also analyze the project payback. That is also more important in this scenario where any companies is going, because in last till date, there are more than 15 projects announced by different PSUs, more than half a megawatt level. Maybe it is SECI, NLC, NTPC, but all these projects are giving different outcomes on financing side. Some projects are giving very high prices on the storage. Some projects are giving very low price, which I give an example. So there is no systematic approach as a whole in the industries and storage as it comes to the market. So we don't want what happened in solar industries. Let's make approach as a holistic approach from the all the sides, not only from developer, also from the startups community, from the diversification community. If you see all these diesel companies, including Cummins, Kirloskar, Sudhir Genset, they all have invested money in the storage technology. If you go for the PSUs like Indian Oil, BHEL, they have also tied up on the manufacturing side. So as it's a more, as I already mentioned 3-4 times, so all the companies should think about from value chain, starting from the raw materials, to implementation. It's not like a solar industry where all the fee fund will come only for the implementation.
So they understood. I think just running short of time. So I think fully understood your point. Rupam had a obviously a response to Devi's points on pricing, etc. So
Devi, I was very well aware that you're talking about hybrid and storage only. See, while you are saying that companies are putting the little finger, there is a reason to it. Why they are putting their little finger and not the complete hand on it. Storage is not something that we have heard just 6 months back or 3 months back. This is something that we have been hearing for like now many years, 1 year, 2 years. But the kind of equipment, the kind of technology, the kind of understanding that we require, that's still not there. For solar industry itself, and I consider battery storage system as a part of solar industry only, they are not apart from it. So considering the way and the time it took for rooftop and ground to mature, it's already 6-7 years that a lot of hardcore work has been done, and all of our, you know, all of us are sitting here and then discussing at that level. Battery and storage are very, very new, and companies who have, you know, put in so much of hard work, they don't want to risk in everything for that thing. Okay, so it would still take some amount of time. Financing is one thing, but you know, before financing, we should be ready with the final blueprint that this has to be done. This is what the final product or the final service would be. This is open to all the panelists. If we have seen projects somewhere around 200 or 500 kilowatt that have been done successfully with the battery storage, but more than that, I personally have to see them if they are very viable and if they make sense to the industry.
I want to say something from the government point of view, you know, like 60 gigawatt on the ground mounted and 40 gigawatt on the rooftop, you know. But how to do the rooftop, you know, before that I'll come back, you know, on the ground mounted itself, you know, something like if the project size is more than 500 megawatt, you know, there is a big challenge, like, you know, what we are talking about the investment and then if the return is not coming, you know. So I have some idea, you know, something like from the developer point of view, if the equity is coming maybe 20 and 30%, you know, if it is a solar project, you know, Eminari has came up with the 10 gigawatt manufacturing based, you know, this kind of a concept, you know. So what we have to do in the two segment in the solar project, one is the DC side, another is the AC side, you know. So in the DC side, the manufacturers of the module as well as all the structures, they have to be part of that, you know, of the investment, yes. On the AC side, there is another company, you know, I don't have to name the company, you know, it has to come in that way, you know. But in the government, the PPA, like, you know, the grid availability and all sort of thing will be there, you know, right? So I don't know what the price, maybe 2 rupees, 40 paise, 50 paise, whatever may be the price. So what I want to say, you know, whether the module is a polycrystalline or it is a monocrystalline or the bifacial, it is the manufacturers of the module, they have to take the stake on that, you know, right? So they have to see on the whether it's a linear degradations or whatever, your module is not working, hotspot, whatever, blah, blah, PID, LID, what is that? You have to take that risk, you know, number one. Number two, I'm coming back to the Tania's questions about the, this is blockchain, you know. So far, we have not experienced this kind of a project, you know. The government has taken the initiative of 100 smart cities to another adding 100, 200 smart cities, you know. We are staying, say, for example, in NCR, there are several cities, you know, I mean, like small, either in the Gurgaon, in Faridabad, in Indirapuram, Ghaziabad, you know, where I stay, there are at least 100 societies. So far, we are paying something like 17 to 18 rupees a per kilowatt, one unit, you know. So in the blockchain, in blockchain is nothing but it is working in the stock exchange. So there will be a minimal of losses of the power, you know. It will be called a local grid. It may be a small grid, micro grid, or something like that, right? But feeding to the grid, you know, is if there is an excess, you know, on that. You know? Say, for example, there is a couple of school and we have a 500 kilowatt installations, and particularly on Saturday and Sundays, they are not working. So where the power will go? So it will be really, you know, intelligently, you know, monitoring of your power, and you get after that, if you meet your demand in a particular, say for example, I am running my air conditioner, so I need more power, you know, in that case I'll manage locally. If there is an excess, then I will send it to the grid, you know, right? So blockchain is a kind of concept. So third thing is that, you know, we have to be a bit careful about in the future, like, you know, so far so much of installation is coming, like 60 gigawatt or so, you know, what will be this kind of the module will do, you know, what will be the environmental impact, how do we do the recycling, whether we have this kind of you know, module will go to the, you know, supply chain where we have procured, they will take it back, you know, something like that. So we have to think forward. So I was attending in a, you know, environmental, Department of Environment as well as, you know, by Terry, there is one of the conference, you know. So the toxic. There are some solar cell or module which are the toxic materials, say for example cadmium telluride and all. So how you handle this kind of a module after it's, when the life is over, whether the life is 20 years or 25 years, it depends on the ROI. If your ROI is over maybe after 14 years, so you'll see my power plant, I want to put another power plant with a better efficiency and all, So a lot of new things has to be come up in the new way, of thinking, So that is my...
Absolutely, thank you for that. I think, technology will certainly lessen cost and change the way...
See, when the manufacturing business will come, the job opportunity, if you talk about 10 gigawatt of, the manufacturing of the module, that means cell or in the value chain, all the material will come. Similar in the blockchain, there will be mechanical, electrical engineer, there will be electronics and the computer science engineer. So this will be competing something like, in future, where we are smartly, monitoring our cable, in the local area, something like that, it will be in a very, very layman's language, So that will, in future, that will be an opportunity for us, So job opportunity, we have to see, how we can deploy manpower in a particular sector,
Right. Unfortunately, we are running out of time, but I think this has been actually a very holistic discussion, because we've talked about various sources of funding, the challenges that we are facing currently in the market, and the steps that we could do to, enable companies like GreenMax, Mr. Kapoor, etc., to have access to that financing. I was going to ask everyone to do closing remarks, but I think there'll be little not enough time for that. So I'm going to ask, Harvinder and Mr. Singh, if you can, from a financier's perspective, give us your closing remarks. What would you want to be done when we are sitting here, next year, reviewing the year that's gone by? And maybe Karan, you can also just, a couple of points from the legal side that you think regulatorily should change over the next 6 months to a year. So, Mr. Singh, Arvinder, and then Karan, you can.
Paul, I think what he was remarking about the disposal of the material. So, I have come across actually with one CEO, Indian CEO of China company. So, what he was suggesting, and he was actually suggesting some business model why actually it cannot be started, that whatever the actually disposable cost will come after 25 years, why not to actually contribute from the day one when this project starts generating? So maybe few paisa, so that can be put it. And even he was suggesting something business model that even if that money is there, so even a loan can also be given against that something. So that is actually some idea, but I do not actually discuss much about that. But that very good idea is suggested, ki how actually to take care of disposal of materials after 25 years. And last time I think RE Investment, this SoftBank gentleman, chairman, he was suggesting that he will give away this entire project. So perhaps that was... free electricity after 25 years. After 25 years. So this was actually announcement made by him. So at that time also, some people start actually doubting whether after 25 years, whether this discount will allow or not allow, and whether the life of project will be there at all. So these two points.
Yeah.
So regarding actually this funding, as far as RERA concerns, so there is no issue actually of funding any projects in. So now we are actually so far in traditionally we were leading in financing only the wind sector. Now it in last 2 years solar has taken over, and we keep on trying also new innovative ideas. So now one issue again during his discussion came this payment, so discounts, delaying payment, etc. For that also, RERA has started one scheme that is a bill discounting. So we can give up to 20 crore rupees and to the extent of 6 months bill. So that we can give. That credit enhancement scheme I discussed, so that also started this thing. So we try to actually give whatever the way.
Innovative schemes.
Innovative
different
schemes.
Customers.
Innovative schemes, and that keep on means repeating.
Change.
and the discounts also in a last financial year, substantial amount we have actually given to discounts, yeah, for this to meet with the, yeah, payment requirement of the discounts.
So I think just, I feel like a TV anchor right now, just 30 seconds each to Harvinder and Karan, and then we can wrap up.
As a concluding remark, what I can say, what we see, there's a lot of appetite for renewable energy financing, not only in India and globally. So, and globally also, we need to have provide them global player the platform for the funding to reach Indian and then be deployed with Indian players at a better cost. So what I also see that market will mature more to for the financing of rooftop and distributed solar projects, where there's still a gap and the people are struggling to get financing. From the developer side, I also expect them to bid for project more wisely and bring more financially viable projects on table. So they will be able to access the funding and get access to innovative projects.
Anand is giving me books. I'm going to keep it really, really short. I think the two changes that are of paramount importance are to ease out the ECB regulations and the FPI regulations for both the debt and the bond market to pick up, foreign debt and bond market to pick up. And the second sort of big change is to have bilateral tie-ups with at least those countries where a lot of supply of modules is coming, to enforce the supply agreement so that, you know, the developers are not facing issues to claim warranties in spite of winning awards. Thanks.
So thank you all of you. Each one of you had a very informative part to contribute. So thanks.
Thank you very much, Aditya ji. I'll now request Mr. Abhilak Singh ji to please present mementos on behalf of the organizers to all the speakers on the stage, please.